What kind of truck was it?
I think it was a 92 Ford F-150.
Nice.
Yep. Not a whole lot of miles, so.
I love Craigslist. They have, like, they have all the best stuff.
Yeah.
Like boats and other transportation vehicles. I brought my goose along. I just thought it would help. A therapy
Your
animal.
Goose?
Yeah, my goose. Why not?
Like a live goose?
Well, not a live goose. It's a plush goose. But he's like my emotional support animal that's not real. It's not living. Oh.
So it's like a stuffed animal.
Yeah, it's a stuffed animal. That's what a plush is.
Okay.
We call a lot of things. Like, if we have... If I had, like, a stuffed animal or, like, a plush person, we call that a stuffed animal. But it's actually just called a plush. But we kind of really use that term, stuffed animal, a lot for anything that's...
Yeah.
Related.
Yeah.
That has that, yeah, stuffiness.
Yeah.
I need a lot today.
Yeah.
You know what the guy's name was?
I think it was something like Carl.
Carl? Carl. Who names a kid Carl these days?
I think it was Carl or something.
Was it with like a K? It's loud. My goose. I love my goose, man.
What's that?
What is that?
It's a 2 liter of Canada Dry ginger ale.
You have 2 liter of it?
I mean...
You just keep it in your car?
I mean, I didn't intentionally think it was funny, but... Like, I drink a lot of it, so I just thought that keeping a 2 liter of it in here would be... Like, just...
Handy.
Cut out the middleman, you know?
Yeah, quench the thirst anytime. I like it. I'm gonna set him up here for a second. I realized, I thought I brought my recorder along. It's pretty windy.
Yeah?
Yeah, I just thought I would bring it.
Just thought you'd bring it?
Yeah, just bring the recorder.
What can you play?
Well, I try to play different songs on the recorder, but it feels like that I can only play one continuous note, no matter how... If I try to put my fingers on it, on, like, the little holes, the note doesn't change at all.
Then why did you bring the recorder if it doesn't play the other notes?
Because I wanted to use... I just thought... Recorders, they're like the little cousins of saxophones.
Yeah. Right.
They're not good. I guess it kind of did change that time. Wait.
I don't hear any
worry.
Difference. Actually,
yeah, what if it
all sounds the same?
Yeah. What do you got in the glove box?
Just a gun.
You just have a gun? You keep a gun in your glove box?
Well, I'm...
It's not in a case or anything?
Well, I mean, it's not been, like, cocked.
Bullets in it?
I think so.
Why would you keep, like, an active gun that someone could use at any time in your glove box that's not locked?
Well, I just...
Put that back in there.
You want a gummy worm?
Yeah, sure, I'll take one.
There you go.
I like the gummy worms that, like, one half is blue and the other one is red. Because that's, like, really good. You want one?
They're mine.
No, I'm just saying. I have
You're going to offer me one of my own gummy worms?
Well, I have a whole bag in my ham. I'm just wondering if you do want one.
Yeah, yes, I want one. They're mine, okay? Give them back.
Okay.
I don't get any more.
What? I wasn't trying to be rude.
No, no. You don't... Stop.
When did the guy say he would be here?
I think around 12:30. It's 12:10 now. What?
I don't know.
What are you laughing at?
Well, you have a full gun in your glove box.
A full gun?
Yes, a full gun.
I don't think it's described as a full gun. I think it's just a gun.
When I say full gun, I mean like it's... you could.
Why are you laughing?
Because you have
a gun.
You have a 2-liter bottle of ginger ale in your own car. And you have gummy worms.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Listen, I stopped at the gas station on the way. I got out, I bought a 2-liter, and I bought gummy worms. I don't see the problem.
Why didn't you get it?
Today. You were with me.
You bought it today?
Yes.
I thought we went to go get gas.
Well, we did. I went inside and got...
Did you get anything gas-related?
Yes. I got a full tank.
And then you got a 2-liter bottle and gummy worms?
Yes. I do not see what the issue is here. I was thirsty. I was hungry. I got two things
That's not really an actual meal. Usually whenever you stop at a gas
station... It's a snack. You don't get a full meal at a gas station, okay? You don't walk in and say, hey, I want a medium rare sirloin steak. You go in looking for crap, okay?
Yeah, but, like, usually when you try to get, like, a snack at a gas station, you only do it, like, when you're going on vacation or something. But this is real life. We are not on vacation.
So?
So don't buy.
People stop and get stuff at gas stations all the time.
Like gas?
Yes, what they are for.
Or things beside gas. I guess station.
I'm gonna call the guy. I'm gonna call him.
A gas station's like a convenience store, right?
I'm calling the guy.
Is a gas station convenience? Do you know what his name is? Oh, yeah, it's Carl. Sorry.
Yeah.
Forgot.
Yeah, let's... Hey, Carl? Hey, Carl, you there?
You just hang up.
I get it. He answered, but it was just... Here, let me try again. Carl! Yeah, hey, it's me. I'm the guy wanting to get the truck. Why is he not... I don't know.
Maybe he's busy or something. Just give him time. He'll come.
But he answered the call and then hang up.
Well, maybe he's driving to us and maybe there's someone at his house that just thinks we're just random people.
What? Wait, okay, wait. So, in your example, he's on his way here, but random people in his house answered my phone call.
No, maybe someone that's just at his house. I don't know who it is, but maybe someone just thinks you're a random guy. Is a gas station a convenience store?
I'm not talking about the gas station anymore. I'm done talking about the gas station.
Okay, is the Dollar General a convenience store?
Okay, I would argue yes. It's a convenience, it has stuff in it that is cheap and not, like, used anywhere else.
I bought my recorder at the Dollar General. I saw it there and I was like, you know what? What the heck? I'm bored. I'll get a recorder. And now, I haven't used it in like a month.
It's been sitting in your closet for...
Yeah, it has. It's not good. It doesn't change. But it was like $1. $2. Somewhere around...
Well, see, that's how they get you. They present, like, subpar products. And you're like, oh, this is going to be like $5 for something that's bad. And they're like, no, it's $1. And then you're like, oh, that's a good deal. And then you end up buying it, even though it's bad.
You just kind of still remember that it's a subpar recording.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're blinded by the price.
That's how they get you, man.
Capitalism, they got it down. They know how to fool their customers.
Yeah, I guess so.
The economy, I should say. I don't know how money, currency, I don't know how any of that works. All I know is that you give the money to the cashier, and they give you the item that you're using the money for. Simple as that. Simple exchange. Do people still barter?
Like what? With like shiny rocks?
No.
Like cavemen?
No. I'm saying like there's two different types of currency. Well, not really currency, but exchange of items. It could be money for something that you want. Wait, a good or service traded for a good or service, or currency traded for a good or service. Do people still do the traded good or service for?
I don't think we barter.
I think people still do. Like the black market.
No. The exact opposite for the black market. The black market takes, like, enormous amounts of money for their products because they're illegal.
I don't even know.
Most of the time. Sometimes they're just kind of shady, but most of the time they can be illegal products. I've got to go pee.
Where are you going to go pee at?
Well, I mean, we're just in the park. I mean, I'll just go pee over there. But I drank too much stuff.
Exactly.
Ginger ale.
That proves you shouldn't have bought the snack at the gas station.
I'm not getting into this again, okay? I bought what I want, and I wanted it.
Okay.
So I got it.
You can go pee in that puddle.
I'm going to go pee.
Okay. Go pee in the puddle. Shouldn't have bought the snacks at the gas station. The note won't change. Absolute trash. I have no idea why I brought that. You shouldn't have bought the snacks at the gas station. Shouldn't eat goose. Goose, my emotional sport animal. I think I'm just gonna call you Goose. Still peeing with the crap? Jeez, how much of that did he drink? Crazy. Okay, now he's coming back. follow this guy. What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, hey. Well, that's nice. He's taking the cup to the trash. Yeah, taking it to the trash can. That's good. Recycling habits. It's nice for them. People are stupid. I'm just gonna throw my trash here. Even though there's like a trash can. And it is a tippy that likes to walk over there. I'll just do it right here. Littering is stupid. There's no need for litter. Where'd he go? Okay. Oh, yeah. There he is.
Threw away a cup.
I was talking to my emotional support animal about how that's good recycling habits, so I give you my utmost respect.
Yeah. See that guy that just pulled up?
Is it Carl?
That may be him.
You know what car he drives?
I thought that he would be driving the truck, but he may have just
maybe that's just
drove here with a friend or something. I don't know. We'll keep an eye on
did
him.
Did you see that?
What?
Something's floating in the river.
It's a stick.
Are you sure?
Yeah. It's a stick.
I wish I had my binoculars. I could see what's flowing over there.
Well, I can see it just fine. It's a stick, man.
Well, it's a weird stick.
Why is it a weird stick?
It doesn't look that big. It looks like...
Well, I mean, sticks... Why is there a universal size for a stick? Can't sticks be any shape?
What do you mean?
Oh, never mind.
I didn't know what you meant by universal size.
Guy's not getting out of the car.
Yeah, I don't think that's him.
It's probably not. Wanna listen to the radio?
Yeah, turn it on. Turn on the car, man. Let's listen to what all those people have to say.
You know, the only reason I know this song is because of the Weird Al parody. I've never actually listened to the original version.
You're kidding.
No.
You listened to the Weird Al parody, but not the actual
song. Well, I mean, like, I knew what the original was, but I've only ever heard the parody version. I've never heard the original.
I think I've heard this version first, and then the Weird Al parody.
Okay. Let's see what else is on.
Yeah, you should probably...
Okay, what does Kentucky do? Number one, we got to protect the football. We have to take, Will Levis has to take what they give us.
Yes, you know,
and sometimes that means throwing the ball away or
he's exactly right.
We have to establish
please
a run,
change
be able
the
to run
channel.
The ball. I think that we can against this defense. Okay. I think that if.
I hate country music.
I'm not a big fan of this stuff.
Is it cold in? Yes! Static!
Why do I just have two channels of static?
You should probably scan. songs.
Let's see.
The size of multiple football fields or lines with.
It was a woman. Then she. Static. He's exactly right. You might stumble. And you might take a fall.
And touch those nail prints that were made for me.
Listen, you know what I like to do on waiting trips like this? So I like to listen to AM radio.
Is there anything on AM radio?
There you go.
That was really good. I always thought AM was just static.
Oh, that one's...
This one's...
I mean, that one's kind of...
creepy.
Rough.
Turn off the radio, man.
Turn the car back off.
There's nothing really good on. Are they not here?
He's still not here yet.
What did he tell you?
He told me he'd meet me at the duck pond, which is where we're at, at 12:30. 12:20? What did I say?
I think you said 12:30.
12:30, okay. Well, it's 12:27 right now. We just have to wait a little bit longer.
Just 3 minutes.
A sip of the Canada Dry?
No, I'm good. I'll get my
I've got plenty
I'll
left.
Get my actual meal at home. Not at a gas station. Okay. Windy.
Windy, yeah. Yeah, I was just about to say that. I was gonna say
me too.
I was gonna go, whoa, this is getting windy. But then we both said windy at the same time.
It kind of pushed
the car a little bit. I felt it sway
a
little bit.
You felt it push the car?
Yeah. I mean, it was strong wind.
I mean, it felt like a big one, but...
Yeah.
The big one. Let's back
up. You know what? I'm going to do something while we're waiting.
Okay.
I'm going to go through some of the stuff in my trunk to kind of clear out some of the clutter. It's kind of been messy
for a
while.
Where
are you going to put it? Well, I'm not going to do anything with it. I'm just going to, like...
Just kind of see what
assess
needs...
Assess it, yeah. See what needs cleaning. Here. There's some cool stuff in the back.
What do you see?
Looks like I've got a big old tent. Some hats. I got a couple of hats.
Okay.
Oh no, a mask.
Oh, should I go get that mask? Ew, that was gross. Well, it's not like anyone was wearing a mask anyways.
A mask I just had blew away with the wind, and now it's all dirty.
Well, it's not like anyone wears masks now these days.
I've also got, the heck?
What?
It's like a...
A rat?
Let me come up there.
Is it a rat?
Neti pot?
When did you get a neti pot? Why do you need a neti pot?
I don't remember getting it. Nasaflow by Dr. Mehta.
Dr. Mehta?
I guess.
Why not? Oh, excuse me. Let me see that.
That was gross.
Sorry.
Why did you burp? You're not even drinking the ginger ale. Why are you burping?
Because I had a gummy worm.
Gummy worms make you burp?
Yeah. They're a natural cause for burping. This is a... There is emerging research suggesting that the hypertonic nasal irrigation, is safe to use and possibly effective in decreasing the viral burden of SARS.
I don't think gummy worms make you burp.
I'm reading this. COV2. As well as reducing the duration of symptoms and infection. This is stupid. Wait. Okay, so it says hypertonic nasal irrigation in an asterisk. This is to make a hypertonic solution, use 2 to 3 blue packets, and in parentheses, 1 to 1.5 green packets per 8 ounces, 240.
So what do you do with it?
I'm not sure. I wish there was just a... Don't have to do with, like, your nose, I think, because it says nasal a lot.
Nasaflow?
Yeah, Nasaflow. Oh, look, it's Nina Mehta on the back. Picture of her, she's wearing.
So.
I think you should try it. Why not now? Not on the car. We don't want Carl to see us with, like, a neti pot. If he even knows what that is.
Well, there's instructions.
Are you actually gonna use this?
I mean, I want to find out what it does.
Okay. Soothing saline nasal rinse.
Saline
rinse. pH balanced.
What the heck? Okay, so apparently you take it and you put it in your nose.
Ugh.
And pour water to clear out your nose.
That is the most uncomfortable sounding thing I've ever heard.
Yeah, it doesn't sound particularly fun.
I mean, there's not a lot of things that are fun. Like, who said taking medicine was fun?
I wonder if you can do it with ginger ale. Because I've got plenty of that.
Do it with ginger ale? That's terrifying. That's honestly terrifying. I could watch a whole movie of just some guy being tortured with ginger ale up his nose, and it would still be a horror movie. It'd be rated R. Still plays when that doesn't change.
I see. See, it's 12:33. Carl isn't here yet.
Well,
let me try calling him again.
Yeah, try to call him again. From Craigslist?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you sound like?
I mean, you just sound like a guy.
How much was the truck?
I mean, it was a good amount. It's about 3,500, not 1,000. Okay. That'd be a little too much.
Dude, how do you have that much money?
Yeah, no.
That's a good price. Wait. Before you call him again, do you really want this truck?
Well, yeah.
Enough to wait here until 1. Oh, sorry. My shoes. Are you texting him?
No, I'm tweeting.
Was that sarcasm?
No. I have Twitter.
Or you're...
Look, I saw this funny video the other day on Twitter. Look.
Okay.
Unless you're gonna like this. You're really gonna like this. Where was it? It was really...
It's really windy out here.
It was a really funny video.
Oh, wait, there's a car.
What?
Is he turning in? Nope.
Oh.
Nope.
Oh, they're just...
I just saw a car.
They're just going past. Oh, okay. Huh. Thought maybe that'd be them.
What color was the truck?
Blue. Where's... I can't find this video.
What happened?
Well, it's... Well, it was kind of hard to explain. It's here somewhere, though. I saw it the other day. I spent like 10 minutes laughing at it. It was really funny. No, sorry, that wasn't it. That was something else.
What's that?
I don't know. I can't find it.
What happened? If you can't find it, just tell me.
You won't. It's one of those things where, like, you can't really explain it. You just gotta kind of see it. Mm. But, yeah, it's...
What time is it right now?
12:36. Oh, right. I was going to call the guy.
Yes.
Where's his number?
Call that Carl.
Sounds like try again.
Sounds like the name of like a sitcom.
Carl? You there? Hello? Get the same thing. He's doing the same thing again. I don't know if this is like, did I get scammed? Well, no. I talked to the guy. I talked to him.
I'm pretty sure you got scammed.
No. I talked to a guy. Look, okay. I gotta try one more time.
You got scammed.
Yeah, maybe I did. I don't know. I'm gonna try anyways.
Well, he's not here.
I'm gonna try. Try again. Oh, it's ringing. Hey, is this Carl?
Hello?
Yeah, is this Carl?
This is Carl.
Yeah, I talked to you a few minutes ago about the truck.
Yeah, the one with the bees.
What? The one with the bees?
Yeah, I told you about it. Okay. It's a white Ford.
Wait, it's white?
White.
I had been told it was blue.
Well, okay. In the right light, it can look a little blue. But it's also hard to tell what color it is because there is a beehive inside, and it is constantly...
You said it was...
...covered in bees.
You said it was drivable, though. Like you said it was...
Well, it works. You just get stung every time you go in and out.
In and out of the truck?
Yeah. What, you think you can get inside a truck that's filled to the brim with bees and not get stung?
I mean, I guess not, but... I was under the impression that this truck was in a little bit better condition... than now, I guess.
Listen. The truck is my baby. It runs as smooth as a stick of butter that's been sitting out all night.
What? So but, it runs smooth despite the fact that there's a hive of bees living inside?
Yes, listen. The bees aren't like clogging up the truck. They just live there. If you could listen... That's why I'm selling it. If you get the bees out, it's a good truck.
Is there any way you would rec...
Yes, there are bees. I told you.
No, it's not really what I was talking about. Is there any way you would recommend getting the bees out? Because I would like to get them out.
Maybe, like, play a little song on a pan pipe and leave them out one by one or something.
I'm not
a biologist. I don't know.
Like the Pied Piper. You recommended to me... Okay.
I don't know any pie poppers. You're gonna need a bee popper.
Wait! I have an idea. Okay, so you know how, like, in the bee movie, they have like that smoker thing.
Smoker?
Yeah, like the thing that blows all the gas at the bees. Get
okay.
One
of those. No. Yeah.
Talking about a green egg and smoke a brisket in. I guess I don't know if bees are vegetarian or not.
Green egg.
Oh, you mean like the stove thing, right?
A smoker, yeah.
Yeah, okay. All right.
That's what I've been telling you this whole time.
I'll look into that more. Are you close to getting to the park?
Well, no. I'm not getting in this truck. It's filled with bees. I've already told you that. I'm not driving it.
Wait, so you're not bringing the truck here?
You sold us a truck. That you're not even
we had both agreed that we would meet up here and sell the truck.
Well, yeah, I mean, I can be up there and I can take your money, but the truck isn't going to be there. It's filled with bees.
Well, how will I get the truck? Because you were very, like, insistent on not giving me your home address. That's why we decided to meet up here in the first place.
That's true. I'll tell you what. I'll give you the address of my neighbor, and then we can meet there and walk over.
Okay. Yeah, I can do that.
All right. Now, how much... What did I tell you I'm asking for?
$3,500.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm thinking maybe less now because it's filled with bees.
Well, some people might think the bees are a bonus. They probably pay a premium for the bees. But, okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah. I don't want the bees.
Wait, do you have a gun in your house at all?
What? Just a singular gun? No, I have multiple.
Oh,
can you just shoot the bees?
Don't do that. Don't shoot the bees, please. That would harm the truck.
It's a simple solution to a complicated problem.
That would harm the truck.
Listen to him.
I will meet you at your neighbor's house, okay? I will meet you at your neighbor's house.
Carl, shoot the bees.
I'll send you a letter in the mail with my neighbor's address, and we can meet there.
Okay. Okay. All right.
Cash only.
Yeah, okay.
All right.
Bye.
Okay, love you. Bye. Ow, dang it.
I'm not entirely sure that guy's not just gonna shoot the truck now. Thanks a lot for that.
It's a simple solution to complicate your problem.
Let's go meet him at his neighbor's house, I guess. Wait on a letter.
Are you sure there are even bees in there at all?
I don't know.
You could just be lying.
I don't know, man. He said a lot of things in that 20 minutes that we were talking, or however long that was.